हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल फिजिक्स पैरामार. सो दिस चैनल इज बेसिकली फॉर दोज हु स्पेशली वांट टू लर्न फिजिक्स एंड आई विल टीच मैनी मोर टॉपिक्स हियर. आई विल पिक अप अ टॉपिक एंड एक्सप्लेन इट इन डिटेल. सो आई स्टार्टेड विद अ वेरी फंडामेंटल थिंग, दैट इज लेजर फंडामेंटल्स एंड ऑपरेशन. सो यू गाइज कैन टेल इन कमेंट्स वॉट ऑल टॉपिक्स यू वॉन्ट मी टू डिस्कस इन माई यूट्यूब चैनल. And I will go through the topics one by one. So firstly, I am going to start in laser fundamentals and operation. So basically here, I have divided this portion into 5 lectures. The first one is mechanism of light emission. And then I'll go through the construction and working of laser. And then I'll go through the modes of laser like transverse and longitudinal modes. Then I'll get an idea of higher level lasers like 3-level or 4-level lasers and all these things. And then I will teach a special type of laser, that is helium neon laser, which you all guys have used in your laboratory if you have done some practicals on laser. Okay, so let us proceed with our very first lecture. So guys, if you want the notification whenever I post the lecture, do subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon there. And also like the video. If you'll especially like the videos, okay? So guys, do like, share and subscribe my channel to get the notification whenever I post the next lecture. This is the very first lecture which I'm going to start. Okay, and you all do tell in the comment section what all improvement can be done and what all lectures or what all topics you want me to discuss here and what all doubts and what all questions you have in your mind. I'll surely reply. Okay, so let us start with the very first lecture, that is laser fundamentals and operation. So lecture one, basically in this lecture, I'll discuss the mechanism of light emission, how light is emitted from a laser. So let us start with our very first one, that is this one. Okay, so let me start. Next one. Okay, so what is laser? What is laser? We all know what is laser. So basically what is laser? It is just a light emission. A light is emitted in a laser. It is light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. Now, it is light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. So stimulated emission, this is a process by which the amplification of light, a photon is emitted and then we amplify that photon, that is amplification of light occurs and then our laser light is emitted. Okay, now you all know what are the properties of a laser light. So a laser light, it is highly monochromatic, as you all know that a single light of a single wavelength is emitted from a laser beam. So a laser beam is highly monochromatic. Then it is directional. And you all know the meaning of directional. Directional means a light is emitted in a particular direction. And that also you all have seen and you all might be knowing that a laser light is directional. Okay. And it is strongly intense. That also you all might be knowing that a laser light is a strongly intense beam. And then perfectly coherent. It is a perfectly coherent light. Perfectly coherent means the photons which come out in this laser beam, they have same frequency as well as same wavelength and they move in a particular direction, that is same direction. So these all properties, you all know that a laser light is highly monochromatic, it is directional, it is strongly intense and it is perfectly coherent. Now, this is the basic idea which I have given about laser. Now, we all know that light is emitted from a laser. Now, how that light is emitted from a laser? We want to know that what all process occurs inside the laser that we get such high intense directional monochromatic coherent beam from a laser. That I'll discuss now. Okay, so mechanism of light emission. So for any atomic system which is an equilibrium, in that the emission of light, it is a result of 3 main processes like absorption, spontaneous emission and then stimulated emission. I'll go through all 3 of them one by one. So let me start. Absorption. So what is absorption? You all might have studied in younger classes or in
secondary or higher secondary, that whenever we strike light on any atom, then it absorbs that photons and gets excited. Same is the process here. A photon, it strikes an atom in ground state, say energy level E1, and then this atom absorbs that photons and goes to higher energy level. This process is called absorption. Now, here I have written something. The rate of absorption, where does it depend? So, guys, you all know that on what does the rate of absorption depends? It depends on the number of atoms in state E1, as I have mentioned here, and the density of incident photons. So, this is the state E1. How many atoms are there? Means, kitne atom hai yahan par is energy level mein. So, this absorption, that is rate of absorption, matlab kitni speed se absorption ho raha hai, it basically depends on how many number of atoms are there in state E1. Obviously, if more atoms are here, then more atoms would go to this state E1. Then from here, it would absorb and go to here. So obviously, more absorption can be seen by us. And density of incident photons. This is the incident photons. So how many photons are incident per unit volume or per unit area? Per unit time, that also. So how many photons are incident per unit time? That determines that what is the density of photons. If more number of photons are incident, then obviously all the atoms, many atoms here would absorb the more number of photons and then they would get excited to higher levels. So obviously more absorption occurs. Okay, now this is the basic absorption process. Now you all know that whenever absorption occurs, then the atom does not remain for much time in that excited state. Then after that, what occurs? It is called spontaneous emission process. So if an atom has reached E2, then it stays there for a particular lifetime of that atom. And then it returns to state E1. This process is called spontaneous emission. That is, an atom from excited state, it returns to ground state. This is called spontaneous emission. Now in this process, a photon emits in a random direction. And this is called spontaneous emission. Okay. Now, on what does the rate of spontaneous emission depends? So here I have written, it depends on the number of atoms in state E2. That is this state E2. Okay. Now, how does it depends on this state? That you guys can understand. And you guys will tell me in comment section that how these number of atoms depends in state E2. Okay. Now, this process is called spontaneous emission. Now, what is spontaneous emission? Whenever an atom gets excited, it will obviously return to ground state after some particular lifetime in that state. So this process is called spontaneous emission. And in this process, a photon is emitted in any random direction. This is called spontaneous emission. Now, what is next? It is stimulated emission. As I've told that three main processes are there, which are involved in this mechanism. Now, what is stimulated emission? Obviously, you guys can understand it. Till this spontaneous emission. Now, what is stimulated? You all have understood here, till here, that is spontaneous. Absorption has occurred. That is, an atom from the ground state has went to the excited state. After that, the atom would have returned to ground state by emitting a photon in any random direction. Now, what happens in stimulated emission? This is the point to be noted. Now, if an atom has reached here, then it had returned to ground state by spontaneous emission. Okay. Now, the photon, this photon, which is emitted in spontaneous emission, it will further trigger atoms in this state to return to ground state. Now, imagine that we are striking photons very fast. Bahut jaldi jaldi photons aa rahe hain. Toh kya hoga? Whatever atoms are there in this state, ground state, it will go to excited state. But you know that atom, it remains in the excited state for a particular lifetime, say 10 raised to minus 8 seconds. Okay, so atom ko excited state mein thodi der ke liye rehna hai. But what happens that more number of atoms has reached here. So if you imagine that any one atom have returned to ground state by itself spontaneously, it is spontaneous emission. Now the photon which has emitted in this spontaneous emission, it will further trigger atoms in this state. Matlab jo aur baki sab atoms hai jo bahut zyada atoms ikatte ho gaye hain, सो स्पॉन्टेनियस इमिशन से निकला हुआ जो फोटोन है वो फर्दर ट्रिगर करेगा एटम्स को एक्साइटेड स्टेट में, मीन्स इट विल फर्दर फोर्स एटम्स इन द एक्साइटेड स्टेट टू रिटर्न टू ग्राउंड स्टेट. दिस इज स्टिमुलेटेड इमिशन. सो वॉट हैपन्स हेयर, वी विल गेट टू फोटॉन्स, वन दिस वन विच इज दिस वन ओल्डर वन एंड दिस इज न्यू फोटोन विच इज बाय द by the what to say by the de-excitation of one more atom. Okay, so what happens, we will get two photons, okay, which have same frequency and are in same direction and have same wavelength also. So these are coherent photons. So मैंने पहले बताया ना कि laser beam is perfectly coherent. So what happens, it is due to this. यहाँ पर क्या हो रहा है, हमें दो photons मिल रहे हैं जो same direction में, मतलब ये दोनों photons coherent है. तो obviously वहां पर जो photon, जो हमने बताया था कि laser beam coherent है, वो इसी वजह से होता है. Because in laser beam stimulated emission occurs. So obviously due to stimulated emission, our laser beam becomes coherent because the photons which come out, they are in same direction. Okay, I think you would have understood this thing. Now here also I have written that the rate of stimulated emission, it depends on the number of atoms in state E2 and the density of incident photons. Kitne atoms hain is state mein, E2 state mein, us pe depend karega. Obviously you can understand, do comment in guys, what is the reason, okay? And density of incident photons, this also I have told in absorption process, that obviously agar incident photons zyada honge to zyada absorption, jaldi jaldi absorption hoga, agar to yahan par zyada atoms collect ho jayenge to obviously ज्यादा एटम्स कलेक्ट हो जाएंगे तो ज्यादा ज्यादा जल्दी जल्दी स्टिमुलेटेड इमिशन होगा, राइट? ओके, सो दिस वाज द स्टिमुलेटेड इमिशन. सो टिल नाउ वी हैव डन द थ्री मेन प्रोसेस व्हिच आर इन्वॉल्वड इन लेजर इमिशन. एब्जॉर्प्शन अकर्स, देन स्पॉन्टेनियस इमिशन, एंड द फोटोन एमिटेड बाय स्पॉन्टेनियस इट फर्दर ट्रिगर स्टिमुलेटेड इमिशन. सो वी गेट थ्री मेन प्रोसेस ऑफ आवर लेजर, राइट? सो दीज आर द थ्री मेन प्रोसेस. नाउ one more thing we need to know in our basic laser thing, population inversion. It is a very very important term for lasing action to occur. Hamara laser kabhi bhi efficient nahi hoga agar population, laser banega hi nahi agar population inversion nahi hai. To hame population inversion achieve karna bahut 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 important hai. So dekho, hamare paas E1 state mein bahut sare atoms hai ground state mein, right? Then excitation occurs and atom reaches to state E2, right? Now what happens, क्या होगा अगर हमारा absorption बहुत जल्दी है, बहुत fast है? जैसे मान लो if we have the lifetime of the state as 10^-8 second, और हमारा absorption इतना fast है कि 10^-8 में वो almost 10 atoms को ऊपर भेज दे रहा है, मतलब excite कर दे रहा है. So obviously if absorption rate is faster than spontaneous rate, then obviously more number of atoms would get collected in state E2 as compared to state E1, obviously. So this condition is called population inversion. Isi condition ko hum population inversion kehte hain, right? So basically population inversion, it is a state of achieving more number of atoms in the excited state compared to ground state. Matlab population inversion is a condition when we have more number of atoms in excited state as compared to ground state. It is a very very essential condition for producing laser. ये population inversion का क्या role है, कैसे है, मैं आगे वाले lectures में, आने वाले lectures में जब मैं laser का construction और working और lasing action बताऊंगी तो मैं पूरा explain करूंगी कि क्या होता है, क्या role होता है हमारे population inversion का हमारे lasing action में, okay? So अगर हम pumping fast करें, अगर हम pumping means, I've not yet described the term pumping. So pumping is that number of photons incident per unit area, per unit time. So agar hum bahut zyada jaldi jaldi photons incident kar rahe hain ya hamara density of incident photons bahut zyada hai to hamara absorption rate bahut zyada hoga. Agar absorption rate bahut zyada hai to bahut zyada atoms hamare is state mein aa jayenge, E2 state mein, right? To agar hamare E2 state mein bahut zyada atoms aa gaye hain to bahut हमारा जो कंडीशन हो जाएगा उस जगह पे, उसको पॉपुलेशन इन्वर्जन कहते हैं. एंड इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कंडीशन फॉर अवर लेजिंग एक्शन. ओके, नाउ नाउ दिस वाज ऑल आई वाज गोइंग टू टेल इन दिस लेक्चर. सो बेसिकली इन द वेरी फर्स्ट लेक्चर आई हैव डिस्कस्ड द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ लाइट एमिशन. I have discussed the total emission, total mechanism by which the light is emitted. Like I have discussed absorption, then spontaneous emission, then stimulated emission. And then the very important thing for our laser is population inversion. And that too I have described here. Now, in the coming lecture, I'll discuss the construction and working of laser. How lasers are constructed and what is the working mechanism? What is the lasing mechanism of a laser? Now, these things, what I've discussed in the, if you are going to appear for CSIR or IIT JAM paper, you'll be asked for these type of questions. And also for your practicals, this thing will be useful. And for your knowledge to learn laser, this is the very basic thing, fundamental of laser. To do anything in nonlinear optics, you have to learn these things in laser. So basically, this was all about lecture one. Now in the coming lecture, I'll discuss the construction and working of laser. So to get the notification when I'll post the next lecture, you all hit the subscribe button and do like this video and share this video, and also tell in the comment section what all things do you like in my video and what all improvements can be done, and do tell the reason for the rate of our stimulated emission and spontaneous emission. Okay guys, so bye bye, wait till the next lecture appears. Thank you.